Hey guys, today we're gonna learn how to read a firing schedule. Hey guys, welcome to Outpost Pottery. My name's MJ Perry. Today we're gonna learn how to read a firing schedule. And to help us, I am going to reference John Britt's amazing book. I know I say this all the time, but if this is not in your collection, in your library, you should get it because it is awesome. I'm gonna leave a link in the description below because I love this book. So we're gonna go over, I'm gonna show you right now how to read a basic electric firing schedule. Now this is not gonna be about gas kilns or wood kilns or soda kilns or salt kilns, any of that stuff we have to deal with the atmosphere inside the kiln, reduction and all that stuff. We're not gonna talk about that at all. This is just a good old fashioned plug into the wall electric kiln like my Olympic kilns here. Now what is a firing schedule? A firing schedule is basically the program that the kiln is gonna go through to get your desired results. Now, in getting your glazes right, there's basically three things you gotta know, three things you gotta reproduce. You have to reproduce the glaze recipe, including the specific gravity of that glaze. You have to reproduce the atmosphere inside that glaze. We're not gonna touch on that. And the third thing is the firing schedule. Different firing schedules would get you different results out of the kiln. So let's jump into this E1 firing schedule. This one's called the fast glaze firing schedule. And basically it's three different segments. Now a segment is made up of three parts. It's made up of the rate of change, whether it's up or down. It's made up of the destination temperature, the temperature you're going after in that segment. And then it's made up of the hold. So three parts, the rate of change, the temperature you're trying to achieve, and then how long you hold at that temperature. And all three of those things make up one segment. Now in a firing schedule, you will have several segments. So segment one in this E1 firing schedule is going from whatever your kiln is starting at, like if room temperature is 30 degrees or if room temperature is 90 degrees, like it is here in Texas, then that will be where you're starting from. That will not be listed. Segment one will go a rate of change of 150 degrees, that's per hour. And I'm reading Fahrenheit, and Celsius, it would be 83 degrees Celsius for every hour. But 150 degrees Fahrenheit every hour change until you get to 220 degrees Fahrenheit. Now it's kind of like a little preheat, just slowly heating the kiln, getting all that water out of your vessels. Now the next segment is this one right here, and this is going from your current temperature, which in this case is 220, all the way to 1978, and it is ramping at a rate of 500 degrees every hour. So it's going pretty fast to get to that temperature straight up. Okay, now this third segment, we're going from our current temperature, which is whatever we're at right now, which in this case is 1978, we're ramping at a rate of 150 Fahrenheit every hour, and we're going all the way up to 2225. So, and then we are not holding at all, as you can see. So we're getting up to that peak temperature, and then no hold there, and then we're done. And then the kiln just naturally tapers off. You see that slow arc, or actually it's a rather abrupt, sharp arc. Down the mountain on the right-hand side. And you know that's going from about hour 6 to hour 24. So most of your time in this firing schedule is just going to be waiting for it to cool down. You're pretty much done after about 6 hours. Okay, I'm going to hop over to the kiln and show you how to program this E1 firing schedule. Okay guys, so I have a Bartlett controller on my Olympic kiln. Now we're going to set this to this E1 easy fast firing schedule. So the first step is we go over here to program and we enter the users. I think 1 through 6 are open. They all have pre-programmed things in them. So I'm gonna choose number 6. Number 6, press enter. Okay, now how many segments are we gonna do? This particular E1 firing has 3 segments. The first one is, so I'm gonna put 3 segments. So now this is asking RA1, what's the rate of change? What's the ramp that you're going? We're gonna change 150 degrees every hour. So I'm gonna put 150. And now it's gonna ask what's your desired temperature. It's preset, I guess, to 2232. We're gonna go to 220 per this recipe. And we are not gonna hold. Okay, let's press enter. Okay, now it's asking for the second ramp. The second ramp, we're going all the way up to 1978 at a rate of 50 degrees per hour Fahrenheit. So it's asking what's the rate of change? What's the ramp? I'm gonna do 500. All the way up to 1978. And we're gonna hold, no hold on this one either. Okay, we're gonna press enter. Okay, ramp three is a ramp of 150 per hour all the way up to 2225. So let's do that. Rate 150 all the way to 2225. And we're, again, there's no hold. So I'm going to press enter. Okay. Alarm codes are on. Okay. Complete. Yep, it's complete. Okay, let's go program review. User six, segments three, ramp, first one's 150 all the way up to 220. Hold for no time. Ramp two is 500 per hour to one, it's 1978, no hold. Ramp three is 150 down or up to 2225, no hold, no delays. Alarm codes are on, error codes are on. This is fire number 145. Okay, so now to start this ramp schedule, all I do is press start. In fact, I'll do it. I'm not gonna fire it, I'm gonna press stop right now. There he goes. All right, that's all you do. That's all there is to it. Okay, guys, thanks for watching. That is the Fast Glaze E1 schedule out of John Britt's firing book, book on glazes. This is the section on firing, and that's the firing E1 for electric kilns. So I'll leave a link to the description in the description below to John's book. Thanks for watching and keep on learning.